Oscar favorite?
Yeah, Jeff Bridges, your old friend. I'd like to see him win.
Oh, fantastic. Well, that's wonderful. I hope you have a spectacular night tonight. Thank you so much for meeting up with us. It's a pleasure.
This is just a great pleasure to meet you. You know, I've seen you on TV in Paris, and now I see you in Paris, and this is just great. Can you just, you know, tell us what you're doing here, how you're experiencing the whole Oscar craziness? I mean, like,
it's a lot of fun. This party in particular is a lot of fun. It's relaxed, people having a good time. Some of the others get a little more nervous.
And what are you personally working on now? Where can we see you next?
You know, I'm a commissioner on the California Horse Racing Board. So, yeah, I love it. I'm having so much fun. But occasionally I work too. So I just finished a film called Highland Park with Danny Glover.
What's your best memory when you look back, you know, your experience on set or maybe even outside, maybe a funny story when you went out? What's your best memory of being in part of this whole world?
You know, I think it would have been my first movie, 10, because of Dudley Moore, because of Blake Edwards, Henry Mancini. It was a magical time for me.
Who are you voting for as best actress, being a woman?
Meryl Streep. Yeah.
Well, thank you so much.
All right.
Questions for you, and I just love to ask, do you think that more moms should be like Raymond's mom?
I think they are like that. That's why it was so successful.
Exactly. And do people ever, you know, pull you into character if they see you walking down the street? Do they always start speaking to you as if you're still in character all the time?
They, you know what they say to me? Raymond is now in 175 countries in the world. 175 countries, and everywhere I go, I travel a lot. They say the same thing. I love you. Thank you for bringing humor into my life.
Yeah, we all do love you. You're spectacular. You're just fabulous. You bring so much to the screen. We really appreciate it, and I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful night tonight. Bye.
Hi. Thank you so much for stopping by for a few minutes with us. Can you show us what you're actually holding?
Check for $30,000 that we collected, and it's for long-term care, the hospital, which they want to close, and we want to give it to the motion picture home as a deposit so that they promise to keep their promise and keep it the hospital open.
I am so happy to have the chance to meet you because I am from Paris and I grew up with the show. I was like, I had to come back from school and I have to watch The Nanny. Yes, it does. And I came to Miami 6 years ago and I still watch The Nanny. I love your voice.
Paris? Oh, I would love to hear me speak French.
You know what's the funniest part? They kept your voice and that's my favorite part.
How could they keep my voice if they're speaking French?
I don't know. They managed to find someone that came close.
Funny.
Sylvia, can you do like a little 5 minutes of Sylvia from The Nanny?
Sylvia.
Call her, call your daughter.
No, actually, my name is not Sylvia, it's Sylvia.
Sylvia.
Sylvia. Yeah. Fran is great. She's on home shopping, selling her skincare.
And what are you doing next?
I offered today. I said, ask her to have me come on. Because I love the natural look. Everything I do is natural.
Thank you so much for stopping by.
Me first?
Okay, good. Thank you so much for taking the time to be with us. We were actually at the GBK Gift 10 yesterday. And I heard that you were there too. Did you play poker?
Yes, I played poker. And it was a crowded field of 18 players and I came in 16th.
That's not so bad.
That's not so good either.
Can you tell us a little bit about, like, what is it on a daily basis to be on set?
Well, on the closer, I'm sure all productions, everybody, you got to be thankful and appreciative that you're actually employed. But on the closer, I have a tough time telling people that I'm on my way to work. I say I'm on my way to play because it's so much fun.
That's exactly what we told our people. We're from Miami and we just said we're working this weekend, but it's actually a lot of fun. So. Okay, quick question from the Oscar. Best actor for you, your choice.
Well, I think all the nominees are great. But it's looking by, you know, all accounts that Jeff Bridges, you know, seems pretty much on route to win. But all the guys who are nominated are really good. So who knows? You never know.
And then the last question. a few words on this event, the Night of 100 Stars.
Oh, well, the Night of 100 Stars is being it's hosted by a really good friend of mine, Norby Walters. This is my 17th time. I just realized that tonight at the Night of 100 Stars. Kathy Moriarty introduced me to it, and I'm so glad she did. And I play poker in Norby's game, and I just love being here.
Thank you so much for stopping by here.
So, I mean, you're this great, great baseball player and athlete that we all love. Who were some of the people growing up that you admired?
In the movies? Well, you know, being an athlete my whole life, I looked up to athletes, and there were guys like Willie Mays and Hank Aaron, and people played for the Minnesota Twins. But if you talk movies, you know, Sidney Poitier, because there wasn't anybody before him, and he stood up straight and tall and said, this is what I want to act in, you know, what kind of movie, and this is how I'm going to portray myself. So he's the man.
Speaking of movies, do you have any favorite sports movies? I mean, I like football movies like Remember the Titans and things of that nature. And League of Their Own is a great baseball movie. Any one that you like?
You know, The Natural was pretty good. Okay. You know, when you talk baseball. But there are a lot of good sports movies. And, you know, but real life sports, you know, that every day it's a movie. And when I'm on ESPN doing my job, I talk about it all the time. So.
That's fantastic. So what's been your favorite moment so far about tonight, and what are you looking forward to for the Academy?
Well, it's been walking the red carpet right now. We don't know. We got to see what's inside in a minute.
You've done quite a lot of impressive different films that people would recognize you from. What's a favorite moment that you've had over the years, that one that stands out in particular?
Oh, my. Well, tonight, you know, Jim Cameron and Kathryn Bigelow are both friends of mine, and they're both up for it. Best director, so I remember, you know, I was thinking about it all day, about Near Dark and some of the other work that she's done, and Jim and I have been in the trenches a lot together, so, but I'm not, whoever gets it, it's already decided right now, it's already in the envelopes, you know, so I'm just rooting for them both, and I'm happy, it's going to be a fun night, and I hope there's a lot of laughs. I mean, they got a couple of funny guys going to do that, you know, so.
Any favorite song, if they could play a song for you that you'd like to prefer to listen to when you're at a party, what song would...
Black Eyed Peas. Black Eyed Peas.
Which song?
Wait. What do you think? No, it's not new. It's an old one. Elephant, in the Elephant album. Oh, God, I can't remember. My mind went blank.
Some song,
no.
That's a good one.
They're all good.
They're all good.
But
they're
I love so the Black Eyed Peas, yeah.
I love them, too.
They get me in a good mood. They get me in a really good mood.
They're a fun group. Thank you so much for meeting up with us.
Thanks for meeting up with Lance.